Hey everybody, so in today's tutorial, I am going to be going to show you how to curl a wig with hot water and also how to do multiple sections of your wig in different parts with heat setting as well. So we're going to go ahead and just get started right on it. I've already kind of started up on this wig, so as you can kind of see, we have a section that's already curled right now. We have a section that was curled, but it has not been pulled out of the curlers yet. And then we have a section of completely straight hair. Nothing's been done with it yet. So the first thing that I'm going to go ahead and do is make sure that I show you how to separate the pre-curled stuff from the stuff that has been curled but hasn't been removed, and then the stuff that will get curled. Because if you get any hot water on these curls, you're going to lose them. And as you can tell, they bounce really, really well right now. And I don't want to lose this quite yet. I will be in the future, but right now I want to keep these curls as well as I can. So the first thing is to just go ahead and lift it all. And it's just kind of grabbing it all and lifting it up. And then, there's one curl that I should probably redo or something. I might do it later. In any case. So it's just lifting it up and kind of twisting it around itself right now. And then kind of just curling it into the wig a little bit. Just so that it kind of creates this mess. And you can see that curl that I was telling you that I need to refix. And then from here, it's just grabbing some little alligator clippies or some larger ones. You can get this at any variety of store or even any sort of hair stylist as well. They will carry these guys. And then it's just a whole bunch of clipping these guys in place. Now, they're not going to be gripping onto the wig too much. It's not going to actually damage the wig in any way, shape, or form. If the wig was still warm, it probably would. But right now, because these curls are completely soft and loose, it's just going to kind of leave them as they are. And it's not pretty. I didn't mean for it to be pretty. There's no reason for it to be pretty. It's just out of the way. Now, like I said, these curlers have already been hit with hot water, but because I want to make sure that there's the separation from the removed from it and will be getting the hot water, I've gone ahead and kept kind of a barrier here. So if these get hit with hot water, it's not really going to do anything for the wig. So from here, we're going to go ahead and start putting these, the wig fibers and curlers, and derpy me forgot to grab them. There is a large variety of different types of curlers that are available. There are the soft foam type ones that you would roll up and then you would fold the ends in together. And they work actually pretty well, but they keep tight curls. So if you want to keep tight curls, go for that one. The ones that I actually use are just kind of the plastic ones. They're just plastic rollers, and then they have this little cage on top that kind of locks the hair in place. These tend to work pretty well, and you can get them in multiple sizes as well. Usually they only come in a pack of a dozen or so, so that's why I'm also doing this in sections, because I only bought two packs, and as much fun as it would be to get more of them, I'm kind of running low on room for wigs, so I prefer this little section at a time type thing. So once you have these guys, you're just going to want to section a part of your wig. And I don't do large amounts of curls at once, at least, you know, I'm not doing this much wig fiber at once. I mean, it's a lot. And it's better to do a small amount at a time, because then you know that everything is going to be hit with the water and you know that everything is going to be curled properly. So I'm just going to go with a small section. And yeah, it does take longer, but I'm sorry, sometimes longer is the better answer to it. And we're just going to grab our little curler, and hopefully this can be visible, and we're going to grab the end. And it's going to be a little bit awkward on this one just because it's not tight, but usually what I do is I'll tighten the wig so that everything is nice and straight and nice and flat. And then I will grab the end, and I apologize, you can't really see it when I do it that way, so I'm just going to do it this way. And I'm going to just gently work the curl, or at least the hair around the curler, until I get to a good stance at the end. And then I just gently roll the wig, pinching where the hairs were. And when the wig is actually tight, it'll start holding the wig in place. So let me go ahead and just kind of do it normally. And again, I apologize, you can't see it right now, but when it starts rolling up, you'll see it a little bit better. There we go. There's always one or two fibers that just doesn't want to hold in place when you first start. And this does take practice, this does take time, so you know, give yourself ample time to get adjusted to this all. Now, as you can see now, the wig itself is pretty tight, like you can see it fighting up here. And that's what I'm after. That is what you're after, is this tightness on the curler. And you just curl it all the way up to where you want the wig to stop curling. I'm basically doing it at the very base of it. And you grab that little clamp thing and you just pop it right on. Plain and simple, that's the new one. And then from here, just grab another section, lather, rinse, repeat. Now, as you could tell, this entire section, once again, is too thick for what I'm after, so I'm gonna go ahead and split it. And it's best to do your wig in a variety of layers. As you can see, it's not just like one huge curl up here. Don't know if a lot of people have seen a lot of those classic movies where the woman, the mother, is waking up and she has all these curls and they're all like curlers and they're all over the place. That's the exact same thing that we're doing right here. And because of the setup of it, you always want to start at kind of the top of the wig and then work your way down. Right now, because I have kind of the top already built and I'm working on the bottom right now, that's why the curls are kind of set the way that they are at this point in time. Now, the nice thing about this is this gives you the capability of doing a lot of different things when it comes to curls. So if you wanted to have just kind of big, loose waves, you can actually get these curlers that are bigger. I've seen them go up to all the way to about 3-inch diameters. And with the 3-inch diameter ones, you do the same setup. You do the same amount of hair that I'm kind of doing now. And then once you heat set it and you remove them, you could just hit it with a brush or a wide tooth comb, and it just kind of waves the wig. It's very gentle and it's very elegant looking as well. If you wanted tighter curls, you could obviously get smaller curlers. Like I said, there's also those foam ones that are available, but I'm not too much of a fan of those, at least for wigs, because the curls are almost too tight. I've had people ask me if pin curls work, which is a classic 1940s World War II type setup. Sorry if the light just adjusted, the cat decided to jump where the light is right now, so I apologize. But where you would grab the hair and then you would kind of curl it into it, and then you would pin it up. It's also known as victory curls, is another way of putting it. I will be honest, you can do that so long as you didn't twist the hair. And when I say twist the hair, I mean you didn't grab the hair and then twist it so it ended up like that and then you put it in the curls. Because if you do that, I will guarantee you, you're just going to end up with a nasty matted mess. You're not going to end up with anything beautiful. You're not going to end up with any sort of curl. To be honest, it ends up looking like a ratted mess. And again, I'm sorry about the lighting adjustments. He's having fun where I put the light. Okay. I apologize. I'm just trying to keep everything occupied, but I can always skip this too. But if you want to heat set your wig using a curling iron, number one, it is possible to do with some of the heat resistant wigs. But number one, you need to make sure that it is a heat resistant wig, because if not, if you put a curling iron in it, it is just going to fall apart on you. I've watched it happen. I've laughed and cried because of it. Laughed because I've seen someone else do it and I was like, I warned you. Cried because I've had it happen because they claimed it was heat resistant and it wasn't. So if you're not completely sure if your wig is heat resistant, don't chance using a curling iron on it. But if you think it is heat resistant, go ahead and try. Just start at the very tips of it and just see if it melts the tips. But the way that you set it up when you are doing a curling iron is very similar set up to what we're doing. You just grab the curling iron, curl it up into the wig, turn the curling iron on then. You don't turn it on while you're curling it, because the tips are going to get hotter that way, because you're going to have to like keep redoing it, and it's just going to get hotter and hotter and hotter. And then there's this higher chance of melting anyway. But what you do is, once it's all rolled up, you turn your curling iron on. You wait a little bit of time until you can start feeling the warmth through the wefts, through the fibers. Once the top layer is warm, and I'm not saying hot, I'm just saying warm to the touch, what you can do then, and this is my preference, is to grab a washcloth, not wet, just a regular washcloth. Put your hand against the curling iron and slide the curling iron out, but keep the curls in there. Once the curls are in there and it's still in that curled shape and still warm, pin those curls in place. Reason why I actually say this is because if you just let go of the wig while it's still warm, it's just gonna restraighten itself out. You have to wait for wig fibers to completely cool before they will take any sort of shape or form. So you have to make sure that the wig fiber is completely cool. So you'd be ending up with something very similar to this. You just wouldn't have the materials in between at all. So that is if you want to do a curling iron setup. And I'll be honest, I do that if I have kind of an emergency, like somebody asked me to take care of a wig and I've got one day to do it. Number one, I chew them out for doing that. But number two, I do it, but I tell them that I can't make guarantees that every single curl is going to be flawless or perfect. But within about 2 hours' time, I'll have a wig like this one, completely curled, and looking decent enough to be photographic worthy, but definitely not something that I would keep as a permanent thing. Two more of these guys, that's it. And yes, this does take a lot of time, so if you have a movie that you're watching, or if you're just listening to some music or anything else like that, this is a wonderful time to actually do this. As you could tell, I am kind of moving a little bit quickly, and it's just because I have had years and years and years of practice of getting these little curlers into place. This is definitely not my first rodeo. It's not my first curled wig. So things like this move a lot swifter for me. So I'm going to warn you, your first wig that you do this on, there's a high chance that you'll be making mistakes, but don't worry about it. Everybody makes mistakes. Everybody has to start at ground zero somewhere. So if you make a mistake, just try again. Keep going. I cannot stress how important it is to just keep going when you make a mistake. You can give up if you want to, but again, speaking from experience, it's better to keep trying and keep learning, and you might figure out an easier way of, you know, putting curlers into a wig, or how to keep that straight line on a costume. So don't give up if you're not confident or if it didn't end up the way that you want it to. Just try again, keep going. So that was the last curl. Our curler. So all of these guys are now in place. So the next step would actually be to boil some hot water and move this over into the bathroom. And I'm going to go ahead and do that. So we're just going to have a quick break, and then I'll kind of show you guys the next step from here. All right, so here we are in the bathroom with our wig in the shower and a pot of boiling hot water. It was actually just whistling a few moments ago. So number one, be careful, it's hot water, obviously. Number two, make sure no little kids or animals are around. There's always the possibility of scalding. But all we need to do now is just pour our hot water onto the wig curls. Now, the first thing that you're gonna notice when you start doing this is that the curls are going to sag, and it's not too noticeable on this one. But when you start doing that, you're going to watch the curls just kind of start dropping. And that's actually the fibers getting heated up with the hot water. And you're just going to kind of pour it all over, making sure not to get some of the other curls that I've already done. If I do, I'll just prepare them later. Alrighty. And now all of the wigs have, or all of the curls have been saturated. Now, as you can see, some of the regular water just got on the straight part. I'm not even going to care right now. But the rest of them have had some sort of moisture on them. I'm just kind of touching them right now. I have thick skin, so it doesn't bother me too much. But I can feel the heat on every single one of them. And so we just have to walk away for a day, day and a half, depending on how long or how thick your curls are. But we want to make sure that the wig is completely cooled, and we also want to make sure that the fibers are completely dry as well, because if you do a moist wig and you try and pull the curls out, it's just not going to work. So we're going to go ahead and just leave it as is for a day and a half, then I'm going to go ahead and pull off the curlers, and we're kind of going to go from the next step from there. Alrighty, so our wig has actually had plenty of time to dry now. Right now, if I actually touch it, the wig fibers themselves feel about room temperature. If it actually feels cold, it means that they're still wet, and it might need a little bit longer to dry. But these guys are now ready to go ahead and get removed. The easiest way to actually remove it is going from the bottom to the top of the wig. So I'm going to go ahead and worry about these bottom curls first. And it's a simple pop off of the casing. And then instead of just unraveling the hair, I'm actually going to take the time and kind of ease it off by training the curls to slide off of it. And that one did not get enough hot water. As you can tell, there is next to no curl in it right now. So hopefully the next one will actually have it. If not, I'm going to have to reset these all completely. Once again, I'm just going to kind of train the curls down. That one has a little bit better. So what this is actually telling me right now is I didn't get enough hot water on these bottom curls, and either I'm going to have to recurl it or I'm going to hit them with a curling iron, which is probably what I'm going to be doing instead. But I'm just going to go ahead and just keep going up the set, hoping that some of them got some curl kept in it, because that would totally be my luck, you know. A little bit better with the curls. Now, what I'm also going to be doing is this row right here. I'm sorry, you can't really see it too well. This row right here is actually kind of the last row before this next section. And if I wanted to do the heat set again, I would want to leave those curlers in place. Just so that I have a little bit of a marker. And also, if the hot water kind of spills on that section, I don't have to worry about it as much because, hey, it's already in the curls at this point in time. There we go. Now we're actually starting to get a little bit better with the curls. So obviously the ones down below just did not get enough hot water at this point in time. So I'm just going to go ahead and train them on my own, take my time. But I at least want to show what these curls can do, or at least how they can look when they're out of the curlers. And this might have also just been, you know, I didn't get the water hot enough or anything else like that. There we go. Now we're starting to get some fun curls. And this is actually all that you really need to do when it comes to curling a wig is curlers, hot water, let rest, and then remove. Pretty easy, pretty simplistic, not too hard to do. And I know you can't really see the curls quite yet that I've pulled out, so just give me a moment. Like I said, I want you guys to kind of see the whole thing. So I figure I might as well remove all of them. There we go. So let me also go ahead and remove the other curls that I also had in place. One more, sorry. There we go. So now you can kind of get a good view of the curls. And like I said, you could see some of the curls down below just didn't get enough of the heat on there, the hot water. So I'm going to go ahead and train them myself. But yeah, curling a wig is not really as hard as a lot of people consider it, and this is also a good way of showing you how you could do section by section by section, and also kind of show you the mistakes that can occasionally happen if you don't get enough hot water. If you're worried about that happening, just grab your wig, flip it upside down, and then pour the hot water across those curls, flip the wig up, and then pour the rest of it across the rest of the curls as well. But hopefully this will help you guys out with any additional wigs that you want to work on, and good luck with everything.